And we're awaiting a statement from the US Attorney General Loretta Lynch in a moment. But first, let's go over to Tino Miles, who was attending the protest last night and witnessed the shootings. He joins us now. Tino, what did you see? What was the atmosphere like?
Yes, sir. I mean, the atmosphere was very calm towards the end of the rally. The gentlemen were thanking everybody for coming out and participating. So a friend of mine, we were actually headed back across the street. And as we were headed back across the street, the officers were telling us, have a good night, you know, be careful, just small talk. We may have gotten 40, maybe 50 yards away from those same officers. And immediately you heard this loud pow, 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 which sounded like a AR-15, M-16. It was a semi-automatic weapon. And when we turned around to look, those same officers that was telling us to have a good night, you saw them hit the ground. Like, and it wasn't just them. It was like four or five officers. That's why I knew when they said two officers were hit, that wasn't correct. Because I saw four or five officers just like belly flop. Like there were a barrage of bullets and they just hit the ground like a grass drill. It didn't seem like a purposeful fall. It seemed like they were hit. Some fell back into the car, then fell, and some just hit straight to the ground. So my friend told me to get on the ground because you could hear bullets ricocheting off the concrete. So I didn't want to get hit. So I dropped to the ground. But then you saw the police officers on horseback. They told us to flee the area, you know, to run. I guess they couldn't pin down where the shooting was coming from. So everybody just began running. But these guys continued to fire back and forth with the police officers. I mean, they were not scared to shoot it out with these guys. And the more we ran, it seemed like the more shots you heard.
And in terms of how you personally view the police, I mean, everybody's been shocked by these killing of mostly young African-American males, but yet you seem to be on pretty cordial terms with the officers who were just doing their job. So maybe tell us a bit about that.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Dallas is has been reported has been a pretty good climate with police officers. There have been some incidences, but we really try to have a good relationship. So the protest, the march really started out very cordial. The officers were very nice. Everybody was. It was a very meaningful protest, but. Unfortunately, due to this situation, I really think it's can equate to maybe like a bully picking on a kid in the playground. And then that kid gets tired of it and eventually comes to school with that knife or comes to school with that gun or comes to school with those brass knuckles. Unfortunately, I hope this is not the situation where we've crossed the threshold to where we have these extremist people who want to exacerbate their cause by doing extreme things like this, but unfortunately, since the tension is so high, it may be reaching that point.
Yeah, this is the puzzle for those of us at this distance. You know, there's clearly tension. There's clearly police officers acting in a bad way. Yet, you know, there were white folk, African Americans, at this rally last night. On the other hand, you know, you've got a black president, you've got a guy, a police chief who's African-American. It's a much more complicated picture than just simply one color and another color.
Right, absolutely. I think a lot of it stems from, like, economic deprivation, housing, education. So it's bigger than just police brutality. And, yes, we do have a black president, black police chief. But a lot of these black people are put in token positions, and it really doesn't trickle down to the mainstream. As we can see, we have athletes, we have celebrities, but those are a minimal amount of people. But the bulk of the people are hurting. The bulk of the people can't find adequate jobs to provide for their families, and a lot of them participate in maybe like an underground economy. And so that tension is really just starts seeming to burst at the seams, unfortunately.
Tino, it's been a pleasure talking to you. Thanks very much for talking us through what happened to you and what you saw. Tino Miles there,
yes, sir.
Joining us from
Thank
Dallas.
You.
Thank you.